Hi everyone. We are nearly at the end of the rebuilding, and actually the rebuilding took place because we wanted a better workflow to get all the gear to you as soon as possible, and also to create the best gear we can make. Because, you know, this is one big thing of our company, of Heusingfeld, that in one end we want to make good products that we want to race and use ourselves. And on the other hand, we want to have and give you good support, because that's what we expect from companies if we buy something from a company. So Sven will tell you some more about this, and I hope you enjoy it. So Sven, take it over from here.
Hey Ronnie, thanks for the introduction. My name is Sven from Heusingfeld, and we're doing a factory tour today in Groningen, the Netherlands. It's a bit raining, so we're going inside quite quickly, but here on the outside, this is the main building. And also on the other side of the street is our latest addition to the headquarters. It's a new storage room. I'm going to take a quick look over there first. All right, so this is the latest bit of warehouse we've added to our premises here. This is not finished yet. The light is not finished. We still need the materials to be able to stock large pallets of products in here. This will mainly be used for packing materials, which take up a lot of space. And also items for events like Interclassics and Sim Racing Expo, they can be stored over here. So this will be a bit of a long-term storage solution for Heusingfeld, because we ran out of space in the other parts of the new building already. So not finished yet, but the latest addition to our Heusingfeld headquarters. All right, next stop is the ground floor warehouse. Ah, small issue here. The lamp is flashing, which means that heavy transport is going on. So we have to wait for a moment until the lamp is out again. All right, lamps off. Let's enter the ground floor warehouse. Follow me. Well, this is the area where all the stocks and materials which we get from our suppliers enter the building. That's organized over here, and beyond this point everything will be scanned in and entered into our warehouse, so we can keep track of every part which enters our building. Here you see a run of brackets for the simple sprint base plates. We have a few ultimate base plates lying here on the right as well. And on the other side here, for example, you see a bit of new stock of simple sprint pedal plates. There's all kinds of materials lying here, which will be entered into a warehouse ready for and waiting for assembly. And then we enter part of the warehouse here on the right side, where we keep all the, mainly the small materials. For example, something we see here on the right. This is a bit of a toolkit which we supply with our sprint pedals. As you can see, everything has a barcode label over here. We keep track of every single material and every movement of these materials within Heusingfeld. We know exactly where it is. And in this part of the warehouse, we roughly have 600 part items available to make all our products. So it's very important to know the exact location and the exact quantities of everything. We're now moving to the next area, which is perhaps the most important area at Heusingfeld headquarters, which is the assembly area. This is where we made some major changes over the past 12 months. We have two main assembly lines, as well as a few smaller side lines and a calibration station at the end. And what we do here is assembly of pedal systems. And how it basically works is that we start with small parts at the beginning of the line. And as the line progresses, you'll see that something which resembles a complete pedal starts to exist. At Heusingfeld, we only do the final assembly of the pedals. We work with partners, for example, laser cutting and powder coating. So the final process of building a pedal is done on this production line. So pretty much every sim pedal, sprint pedal, which you get has been built over here. This is part of the simple sprint brake assembly. This is the rear part of the brake assembly, which is built together. Here you see a few pedal arms lying around. So currently we're working on assembly of sprint brake pedals. Another important part of assembly is, of course, quality. And one of the things we use for that are these assembly manuals. For every product, for every station, every assembly step we take, there's a manual. So if there's any doubt about which parts we need to use or which steps you have to take, you can refer to one of these manuals over here. Now we're entering upstairs part of our office in Heusinkveld factory. This is the canteen actually. Up until a year ago, this pretty much was all the office space we had. But with the growth of the company, the canteen has moved to this part. And we added some entertainment as well, so we can relax a bit during the breaks and on Friday afternoon. It's a darts board, pool table, and two pinball machines as well. And they actually work. So it's nice to sit here and just relax a bit from time to time. Yeah?
Shooting a video, come on!
Oh, all right, let's go! Okay, so this is the next area at Heusinkveld. This is actually also part of the canteen, but for people who maybe visited us earlier or saw older videos, this actually was our old office space up until a year ago. So, where we currently have lunch, there used to be desks in this place. And now we eat here. Also part of the canteen is the kitchen. Because there are quite a few people working at Heusinkveld right now, over 25. We needed to do some investments, and the main one is the four at one time tosti machine, which helps us create hot sandwiches during lunch. The next stop is the dressing room. This is also a relatively new addition. In assembly and warehousing, we do work with standardized clothing as well as with safety shoes. That was the RoboVac, which has now been destroyed, maybe.
Oh boy!
In any case, because we do a lot of heavy lifting of heavy stuff, people in assembly warehousing, they have to wear safety shoes as well as standardized clothing, so no pieces of clothing can get mixed up with any machinery which we have. So we actually have a dressing room right now with lockers where people can put their stuff when they start working in the morning.
And this used to be?
This used to be the old Heusinkveld demonstration room. We still have an image of one of our customers here on the wall. Right there in the corner is Simon Dolan. He won Le Mans LMP2 a few years back. So old demonstration room, currently the dressing room at Heusinkveld. We're now in the top floor warehouse, and this is where we store all the assembled products which have come from the assembly line. And it's a bit of a special area actually, because for quite a long time we didn't have any stock because we were always sold out. But with all the advancements we made in the production area, we're actually having a healthy amount of stock ready to ship right now. Okay, so currently Justin and Steven are packing orders, and they're going all over the world really. So where's this one going?
This one is going to Italy.
Ah, it's going to Italy. So it's going to be picked up by UPS today, and it will be in Italy in a few days from now. All right. Now entering office space again, come to a quite important room, which is a conference room. Seems we're talking at the moment, but let's take a quick look. Aha. It's Michael, floor manager, Remco, operations manager, and Arnold, who's responsible for human resource management. This has become a very important room, also because of COVID, we're doing a lot of video conferencing from this area. So, well-used place in the building.
Bye-bye.
Then, on to the next part of the office, which is actually the largest room in the whole office space. There's several people working here, Ronnie, including you. Your workplace, of course, see behind you, used for video editing, photo editing. And we currently also have Caro at work here, who's doing graphics design. And it appears she's working on some branding for the building right now, but also responsible for packaging materials and how they look. Okay, on to the next office. This is where Jordi works, one of our product engineers, and also where Mark works. He's responsible for purchasing and account manager for the business market. There will be a few things blurred in this room because some development is going on over here. We've got a cool piece of artwork from Max Verstappen on the wall here. Maybe you wonder why the office is empty. Because of COVID-19, we tend to work a lot of home nowadays when it's possible. So there are two empty spaces. Sometimes they're here when they have to be here, but when they're not here, they're probably able to work from home and do as much as work possible from there. Okay, quick look into the next office, which is the office from Niels, the man himself. Niels also working from home today. And yeah, it's a bit of an empty office. And we've already been here for a year, but he still has to assemble a bit of furniture. And also the walls are still quite empty, but I think Niels has something cool over here. I'm not exactly sure. You may be aware that Niels, of course, has been doing work in Automobilista in the past. This is an Emerson Fittipaldi car, also with Emerson Fittipaldi signature. So he still needs to frame it. But so it's empty here right now, but some cool stuff going to be on the wall here soon. It's also a nice piece just to show. It's a small display case with some sim racing memories from people who work here. We've got a few boxes of a few really old titles. I think the oldest one is Accolade Grand Prix. There at the top. Another very special thing is a lot of people who work here, we met each other during university. And in 2006, we built our very first, our own pedal set. So here in the display case is something which we made with a team of 5 people. And it's maybe probably the first sim racing load cell brake pedal ever. And we still have a few examples of them. So we have them on permanent display here, just as a memory of times when we were still at university and not having to worry about work too much. Final step into the last office, which is jointly my office and also the office from Remco, the operations manager. That's an easy place to work, but we got 2 cool things here as well on the walls, and they belong to Remco. Piece of art of Jackie Stewart. It has been signed by Jackie himself. And over here we have someone else, Juan Manuel Fangio, and also autographed by the man himself. And Remco has a photo to prove it. So it's cool stuff of art on the wall from private collection, but we hang it here and now we can look at it every day, which is nice. All right, we're on our way to the research and development rooms. Follow me. This is also the door where we receive all the support shipments. Not too much going on at the moment, which is a good thing, I guess. Then into the R&D testing room. It is actually really hot in here because we have a serious compressor here which provides air pressure for all the testing machines. But this area allows us to do durability testing on products. And depending on how quick we set the machines, we can do, for example, 1 million of presses on a brake pedal in a fairly short period of time. So this is an important room for us for testing. We also have a 3D printer here and some other equipment which helps us with prototyping of new products. So this is an important room for us. Normally Niels and Jordi spent quite a lot of time in this place.
Where do you bring us now, Sven?
Well, we're going to another R&D room. It's a small workbench here, which is mainly used for assembling prototypes. So that can be done over here. It's pretty clean here actually at the moment. In the drawer over on the right here, we have a location where we stash some of her prototypes. And it's probably a big blur in the video because we don't want to show off everything, but if we have new things, we tend to assemble them here for the first time. We also have a simulator, so we can do some quick testing work. And another useful room for product development. We're almost at the end of the tour. We're going towards the final location. Small coffee corner here on the right. Don't use it that much, a bit more often now because we split the brakes a bit because of COVID-19. We're back at one of the entrances again, and this is our demonstration room. We have 2 simulators here, so sometimes you have customers coming over, or suppliers coming over, or resellers coming over who visit us. And then we can show off some of our products, or in general, drive a few laps on the simulator, here. And we've got 2 of them right now. And some of our products are displayed here at the end of this room. And this pretty much wraps up the Heusfeld factory tour. We hope you enjoyed it, maybe learned a bit more about the company and the way we work. And I want to thank you for watching, and we hope you liked it.